barely get out of the way as they fired their weapons in protection of their own lives.
An Omaha police officer and a U.S. Marshal open fire when a man targets them with his pickup. New details one day after the fatal shooting at a West Omaha shopping center. Good evening. I'm Rob McCartney.
And I'm Brandi Peterson. Officer Jeff Gassaway and a U.S. Marshal, not named due to federal regulations, fired 4 to 5 shots Monday afternoon. Both are part of the Metro Area Fugitive Task Force. Just one bullet hit 35-year-old Joe Weibel, a wanted suspect accused of assaulting and strangling a woman. Weibel died shortly after Monday's shooting near 120th and West Center. Investigators say Weibel used his pickup as a weapon. He had knives with him, but no gun. Big story coverage live at 6 with more on the decision to open fire in a shopping center parking lot. Michelle Bandur has more.
Brandi, the Omaha police chief calls that domestic violence suspect dangerous and that he needed to be off the streets. The chief said had the officer and that deputy marshal not fired their weapons, they probably would have been killed instead of the suspect.
A week-long investigation leads the Metro Area Fugitive Task Force to the Baker's parking lot Monday afternoon. Officers and marshals had been looking for Joe Weibel, accused of sexually assaulting his girlfriend and strangling her until she passed out November 29th. Weibel, a convicted felon for a different sexual assault, thought he was meeting her in a public place. Instead, the task force cornered him in his pickup truck.
We don't get to pick the location where these events happen, and you're thrust into a situation where you have to use deadly force. It happens where it happens at.
Chief Hayes says Weibel tried to run over Officer Jeff Gassaway and the unnamed U.S. Deputy Marshal. Between both men, Hayes says they fired their weapons 4 to 5 times. It was one single gunshot that killed Weibel. Another marshal fired his taser.
It's a deadly weapon. It's, you know, depending on the type of truck or car that it is, it can be anywhere from 3,000 to 6,000 pounds. It will kill you if you don't get out of the way or try to stop it.
44-year-old Officer Gassaway has been on the Omaha Police Force 13 years, the task force 3 years. The I-team followed Gassaway and the fugitive task force in a special report earlier this year. He's now on paid leave pending the internal investigation to determine if the shooting was justified.
He will also have to go through a series of testing with a psychologist to make sure that he's fit for duty to come back to work and that he is mentally okay, and not too shaken from the event.
Well, as for that U.S. Deputy Marshal, who is unnamed at this time, will also have to be on paid leave during the Marshal's own internal investigation. Brandi.
Michelle, I know the I-team's been checking. Has Officer Gassaway fired his gun before?
It was actually happened, yes, 2 years ago. It was a similar situation with a suspect who also tried to run him over with his car. That suspect did survive, and Gassaway was cleared of the shooting and returned to the task force. Brandi.
Michelle Bandur reporting live. Thank you, Michelle.
You bet.
We detailed the case against suspect Joe Weibel in our coverage Monday. The 35-year-old was a wanted fugitive accused of sexually assaulting and strangling a woman he had been living with. The alleged incident took place in a Southwest Omaha apartment late last month. The victim in that case is the same woman Weibel thought he was meeting yesterday.